Anand M. Saxena, a scientist by profession, has taken to research on non-scientific subjects now. His second book, The Vegetarian Imperative, was launched recently in Manhattan. The book talks about the impact of our food choices on the environment. Here's a report of this event by Ashok Vyas.
But the important thing is, how many resources do we need? And that is extremely important, particularly because we are running short of some of the resources. So compared to a vegetarian diet, a meat-based diet needs 4.4, I'll show you why I'm talking about the range, to 26 times more water, 6 to 20 times more fossil fuel, 7 times more phosphate rock. You may not consider it important, but we are running out of phosphate rocks.
There seems to be some connection between the kind of diet we have and it also has some environmental impact. That is probably one of the angles which I see is coming across from this book. What is it that you think about this particular area in terms of what we eat, and is there any relationship with the environment to that diet?
I actually haven't given that a lot of thought in terms of what I eat in relationship to the environment. I think about that I don't drive, and I think about other ways, but it never really occurred to me that my diet was impacting the environment. So with this revelation, will certainly be something I'll apply.
Tell me, Anandji, why this idea of having one more book talking about vegetarianism?
It's not really, I didn't write the book because I wanted to be a writer or because I wanted to write the book. It's because I feel very strongly that we should be aware of the choice of food, and I strongly feel that we have to change, because if we don't change, then as soon as within the lifetime of our children, we might have serious problems regarding the availability of food. And also the second part is, food is so important determinant of health, and a vegetarian diet is infinitely superior than meat-based diet. And I just wanted to bring this information out to people, not particularly because I wanted to be a writer.
You said the vegetarian diet is infinite or many times superior to the non-vegetarian diet. Is it something to do with the religious preference or the religious background that you come from, or this is applicable for the humanity at large, universally?
Well, actually, the religion plays a part, but actually a minor part, because I did become a non-vegetarian by force when I came to this country, and then my switch back to vegetarianism was purely because of scientific reasons. So, I mean, I am Hindu, and I strongly believe that killing animals for food is wrong, but that is not the message that I'm taking out to people. I'm taking the message out that if we want to look at the future of humanity, sustainability, then it is important for us to change our diet.
Vijayadashmi was celebrated at Shirdi Sai Cultural and Community Center in Islay, New Jersey last Thursday. Vishwayogi Vishwamji Maharaj from Vishwa Mandir, Guntur, Andhra Pradesh, participated and delivered his message on the occasion of the Mahasamadhi of Shirdi Sai Baba. Shami Puja and Ayud Puja was also performed in his presence. Ashok Vyas has a report from that event.
ॐ श्री साई नाथाय नमः
ॐ श्री साई नाथाय नमः
ॐ श्री साई नाथाय नमः
रघुपति राघव राजानां अतीत पावन साई राम
वाइब्रेशन टुडे इन हिज फेस the jubilance, the aura, you can see from his face there, he's as if he's sitting there. So I want everyone to concentrate on Baba and ask for his blessings for all the things we do in our life.
Mahasamadhi is a very important day for me because it is a moment of understanding myself better, as I realize even the great Mahan like Baba has got a start and an end in his physical form, but the energy and the form that continues to survive is still a part of all of us. So it's a wonderful day for all of us. Wish all the devotees a great time on Mahasamadhi. Think of Baba, live the Baba ideals, and we continue to move forward with the Baba Tattvam.
Everybody go Dasara Savam. Happy Dasara. Balke Shuru Karram. Today, India mein idhar all devotees ko Mata Ji ka, Baba ka aashish hona. Last 9 days se ye mandir mein daily puja chal rahe. Mata Ji ka sthapana ho gaya. Daily different alankarna, you know, right? First day Malati Prasandri, next day Kaumari, third day Annapurna, Meenakshi, Saraswati, Durga, Mahishasramardhani, right? Today Rajarajasri Alankara.
ॐ सर्वदा ईश्यावतिधेनः ब्रह्मानन्दं भरतस्वरं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं खगरसदृशं तत्त्वमस्याद् लक्ष्यम्.
It is about service to the humanity, and Swamiji always talks about the peace and integration of the humanity, and some of the work the Swamiji has done at the United Nations, trying to bring the community together, and in these difficult times where there are so many wars are being fought, if only we can eliminate the misunderstanding and live peacefully and respect each other, I think what a wonderful accomplishment that would be.
Akhyatma Ramayana.
Om Sai Nath Jai, Sri Sai Nath Jai. Sai Nath Jai, Sri Sai Nath Jai.
Om Sai Nath Jai, Sri Sai Nath Jai.
Om Sri Sai Ram Gurudeva Datta.
Om Sri Sai Ram Gurudeva
Datta.
Om Sri Sai Ram Gurudeva Datta.
Eastern South Governor,
so we did Shami Puja today. What is the significance of that, and also Ayudh Pujan and the arrow and bow that you were operating? What was it?
The deity, Aparajita deity, is residing, existing, semi tree. In the sloka itself, semi samayate. Manan chesina, what we did was a sin, all the sin. The deity, the Aparajita Devi, is taking away all the sin, all the impurities from our body, mind, and it gives victory. Victory. What is that victory? For what purpose? Only to spread love and peace. Love and peace. Love and peace. So we targeted arrows in the 8 corners, not 8, 11 corners. For what purpose? These are all not nuclear weapons, but premastras. Premastra. To take away all the impurities, all the negative forces, all the terrorist activities, and to make each and every individual peaceful so as he can bring peace to the world.
One has to know, science can do only so much. Our mind can go only so much. Beyond that, there is so much we don't know. That's what I'm trying to explore with the help of Swamiji here. And the purpose of my constructing the mandirs here and in New York, in Islin, is to bring all the devotees, and I strongly believe in the principles and philosophy of Shirdi Sai Baba and Swamiji Visayoga Viswanji.